Agent-based modelling has become an increasingly important tool for learners studying social and biological systems. Sometimes referred to as individual-based modelling, it's used to simulate the actions and interactions of autonomous agents, both individual and collective entities, such as organisations or groups, with a view to assessing their effects on the system as a whole. The Modelling for All project at the Learning Technologies Group, University of Oxford, has developed the BehaviourComposer tool. This enables scholars to create agent-based models with little prior knowledge of programming or computer science, opening up this area of investigation to much wider audiences in teaching, learning, research and outreach.
Agent-based modeling is a computer modeling technique that's particularly well-suited for modeling systems consisting of heterogeneous interacting individuals. Josh Epstein from the Brookings Institute recently wrote a paper called Why Model, where he presents 16 reasons other than prediction for modeling. Of course, prediction is an important one, but it's the obvious one. And among those 16 reasons, they include generating explanations, guiding data collection, discovering new questions, and illuminating core dynamics and uncertainties. In order to run one's theory in a computer, they need to be fully and precisely specified, which could be a good thing in itself. But more importantly, they then can be executed by computers to perform virtual experiments. We developed the Behavior Composer to make agent-based modeling accessible to students and researchers without requiring that they first master a computer programming language. It supports high-level model building, where one browses for pre-built behaviors that can be combined and customized to become an agent-based model. In contrast to running pre-built black box models, with the Behavior Composer, students get first-hand experience with modeling. The components, behaviors, and assumptions of the model are visible and manipulable by the students. Students not only learn about the underlying processes and dynamics of systems, but they also acquire some computer modeling literacy.
The benefits of agent-based modeling are that, particularly for non-practical and technical students, you can create a huge amount of complexity from a very, very simple framework. So you can pick and choose and add components and create a model which has grown into a huge complex simulation. And if you wanted to do this using more traditional approaches, you would have to have years and years of mathematical experience and build a model which would take about four times as long.
What I like about ABM and the Behavior Composer in particular is that the interface and the whole approach are very intuitive, so people can get into modeling without having to overcome the barriers that are sometimes there for people when dealing with more abstract aspects of mathematics.
Well, they're both very similar and should theoretically give the same answer. The differences lie in that agent-based modeling, you don't need to specify everything at once. So you take small mathematical nuggets and you put them together and then you put that into a model. And that model will be analogous to the one that you've done in the mathematical framework, except the mathematical model will be much more difficult to interpret and much more difficult to create in the first place. Mm-hmm. So it's like taking small bits and pieces and putting them together and creating something that works rather than starting with something huge and not being able to know what to do.
We've worked with academics here who want to offer practical sessions to their students in computer modelling. At the Say Business School, we have built a model called the Sugarscape, and students get to build that model over 3 hours. And in zoology, we had students building a model where a virus spreads over different types of social networks. We've also worked with zoology as part of a stand at the Royal Society Summer Science Exhibition 15 months ago, where we've had 6 to 60-year-olds building models of viruses spreading through populations, and they get to discuss it with us as well.
So together, lots of us from the university made a whole stand that was all about emerging infectious diseases, and one big part of that stand was using Behaviour Composer for members of the public to actually make mathematical models, and that's what I really liked about it. They didn't just come and play with a model that somebody else had made, they were able to make their own model.
Agent-based modelling and the Behaviour Composer has also been used by an academic here in anthropology who wanted to further analyse their theory about how religions spread and evolve over time. to work with academics at Oxford to offer agent-based modelling sessions, we work our way through a number of steps. First of all, we do some planning with the academics. We decide what kind of model we want to build and specifically what kind of questions we want to study. Once we've done that, we build a library of behaviours, which are small bits of code that are embedded in web pages. So these are the components that students will put together to build their model. Running the session, typically a 3-hour exercise, is perhaps the easiest bit. The tutor normally gives a very brief introduction, and then the students just get on with working their way through a number of steps to the guide. They work in pairs, so that allows them to discuss what they're doing. They gather the data collectively as a class. We project it onto the wall so we can discuss the experimental data they've gathered, and we might call that in silico experimental data. And then they answer the questions. All the questions are aggregated together, which we send them back after the session with some ideal answers from the tutor.
A lot of the students really, really liked it, especially because they were comparing this to a more traditional modelling practical, and the students absolutely enjoyed it. Most of them said they felt like they were playing a computer game.
I think agent-based modelling is relevant to the general public for the similar reasons of low barriers to entry. So people can come along and experience those thought processes of trying to figure out, well, which bit do I think is most important, and then build those into a model and explore the interactions that they're interested in.
My grand vision is that agent-based modeling will become a new way of thinking about problems and systems. Learners will use computers to clarify, elaborate, and discover the consequences of their theories of dynamic processes in their field of study.
I think agent-based modeling is going to be a very important skill for people to have in the future. This is because we're seeing computer models and agent-based models increasingly being used to inform decisions in professional life. As we offer introductory sessions here at OECS, more and more people are starting to see that agent-based modelling is valuable, but also that it's eminently doable, and they're getting interest in offering it to their students as well.